Hello friends, today we are going to start a new chapter called limit. So before coming to the concept of limit, let us understand what limit means. Limit means if we consider a function, when x approaches a certain value from the both sides, that is, if the function is like this, when we approach x to a certain point A, that will approach from the left side as well as from the right side. So according to the approach of x towards A, f of x will approach to a certain value. So here the f of x stands here. So the function approach will be towards f of A from the left side as well as from the right side. It will approach to the value f of A. Now here the function is continuous throughout the real numbers. But what will happen when we consider a function which is not continuous, or there is a break between the function, the graph, in the graph of the function? Here let us consider this function. If we approach x equals to, or x tends to A, when we approach towards A, the f of x from the left side, it will approach to this value, and from the right side f of x will approach to this value. Let us say f of x1 and here f of x2. So in both the case, f of x doesn't approach to the same value when x approach to a certain value A, unlike the previous case. Here when we approach A, f of x approaches a certain value, but in this case f of x does not approach a fixed value or a certain value from the both end. It approaches some value in case of left hand side and some other value in case of right hand side. So when x approaches A, f of x does not approach to a certain value. In this case, we can say that the limit of the function does not exist. In the second case, in case of the first function, the limit exists. That is, more or less, limit is about approaching a certain value. So when x approaches a certain value, if according to that f of x approaches a fixed value from the both end, from the left hand side end and from the right hand side end, in that case we can say that limit of a certain function or f of x exists at a certain point. At a certain point is more important, because we cannot say limit of the function exists throughout R or all over R. So if we consider the limit, then we have to consider the limit of a function at a fixed point or a certain point A. So in the neighborhood of that point, we will consider what limit is, what the behavior of the function is. Now come to the definition of limit. First we will see the formal definition, then we'll go for the informal one. The formal definition of limit says, for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than 0 such that x minus, let us understand the concept of limit by taking an example. Let us take f of x is equal to x plus 2. So first we'll build a table for this x, and here the value f of x. when we take x equal to 2, f of x will be 4. When we take x equal to 2.1, that is, we are moving toward the right of x, right of 2. So f of x will be 4.1. Similarly, for x equal to 2.2, it will be 4.2. For 2.3, it will be 4.3. Similarly, if we come to the left of the point x equal to 2, that is, if we take 1.9 as the value of x, f of x will be 3.9. Similarly, for 1.8, the value of f of x will be 3.8. So if we check here, when we move towards the right, that is, when we approach x to the value 2, the f of x approaches to 4. Here we come, we move to 2 from 1.8, then the functional value is 3.8. when we go to 1.9, the functional value is 3.9. at x equal to 2, the functional value is 4. Similarly, from the right side, that is, from the right hand side, if we move towards, or if we approach to the value x equal to 2, then f of x is also approaching to 4. For 2.3, f of x 4.3. for 2.2, f of x equal to 4.2. for x equal to 2.1, f of x equal to 4.1. so we can notice that from both the end, when x approaches a certain value 2, f of x approaches to a certain value 4. In this case, we can say that limit of f of x is equal to 4 when x approaches or tends to 2. This is read as x tends to 2. So the notation of limit x tends to 2 f of x, and the value for that is 4. Now, coming to the definition of limit, for the limit of a function f of x to be exist at a certain point x equal to a, that is, limit of f of x when x approaches a, if this has to be existed, so before that we have to consider the left hand side limit and the right hand side limit. For this, the LHL, that is, the left hand side limit of f of x, must be equal to the right hand side limit of f of x. Now, the point is how to define LHL and how to define RHL. So, as we have mentioned earlier, that we move towards a certain value x equal to a from the left side as well as from the right side. So, when we move towards x, here x tends to a, from the left hand side, that is, a minus here means a minus h. A minus means a minus h, where h is a positive quantity and h is a very small positive quantity, that is, we can say, in other words, h tends to 0. Limit x tends to a minus f of x, and in case of RHL, limit x tends to a plus means a plus h, for the same condition of h. Now, if these two limits are equal, so before that they have to be exist. LHL must exist and RHL must exist, and they both are equal, then only we can say that the limit of f of x at a certain point x equal to a exists, and that is equal to a certain value, let's say it L. If LHL equal to RHL equal to a certain value L, we can say limit of f of x when x tends to a is equal to L. So the limiting value of fx when x approaches a certain value a is equal to L. Now let us take another example. Limit of x square when x approaches 0. When x approaches 0, that is limit x tends to 0 minus, here it is LHL, that is left hand side limit of f of x. So limit h tends to 0, or here we can put 0 minus h the square. Here we have changed the variable that approached here to 0 minus, here it is h tends to 0, and in place of x we have put 0 minus h. So the limit is limit h tends to 0 minus h the square, that is limit h tends to 0 h square. So if we now put the value of h in the function, it will become 0 the square equal to 0. Similarly for RHL, the limit is limit x tends to 0 plus x square, that we can rewrite as limit x tends to 0, 0 plus h the whole square. Now limit x tends to 0 h square. So when you put the value of h, that is 0 here, it will become 0. Hence here LHL equal to RHL, and that is equal to 0. So the limit of f of x equal to x square exists at x equal to 0, and the limit, the value of the limit of the function f of x equal to x square is equal to is 0, that is L is here is equal to 0. Now in case of limit, we will consider a form that is indeterminate. Before that, let us discuss some more concept about limit. So here I am considering a function which is defined like this. At a certain point, that is a here, the function is not defined. Taking another function where at a certain point a, the function is defined, but when approaches f of x approaches towards the value, that is L here, so f of a which is here is not equal to L. Here f of a is not defined, and here another function f of a, here f of a is defined, but f of a is not equal to L. Here f of a is defined and f of a is equal to L. In the three cases, in the first case f of a is not defined, and in the second case f of a is defined but it is not equal to L. In the third case, f of a is defined and it is equal to L. In the three case, all the three case, here the limit of f of x exists at x equal to a. It doesn't matter whether the value of f of a is defined at that point or not. So what matters is when we approach x towards a certain value a, f of x must approach to a certain value. It doesn't matter whether the value at that point is defined or not, or the value at that point is equal to the value of the limit or not, equal to the value to which f of x approaches or not. In all the cases, the limit here exists in all the three cases. Thank you.